बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। सब्जेक्ट इज़ प्रिंसिपल ऑफ ऑडिटिंग एंड लेक्चर इज़ ऑन वाउचिंग। दिस इज़ फोर्थ लेक्चर ऑन वाउचिंग। टॉपिक टू बी डिस्कस्ड इन टुडे लेक्चर आर वाउचिंग ऑफ पेमेंट, वाउचिंग ऑफ डिफर्ड रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर्स, वाउचिंग ऑफ प्रिलिमिनरी एक्सपेंसेस, वाउचिंग ऑफ कास्ट ऑफ इशूइंग शेयर्स, वाउचिंग ऑफ अंडरराइटिंग कमीशन। वाउचिंग ऑफ पेमेंट, एज वी डिस्कस्ड अर्लियर दैट वाउचिंग इज द वेरी एसेंस ऑफ ऑडिटिंग। द होल सक्सेस ऑफ द ऑडिट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द इंटेलिजेंट एंड स्किल्स विद विच दिस पार्ट ऑफ द वर्क इज परफॉर्म्ड। वाउचिंग वाज डिफाइंड एज include examination of every business transaction with its supporting documentary evidence, the checking of which enables the auditor to satisfy himself that the transactions are in order. So today we will only discuss the vouching of payment. Bills payable should be honored on the date of maturity and are returned by the payee after receiving the payment. These bills should be cancelled after being paid. Bills payable paid can be vouched with bills book. If payment is made by the bank, bank statement or passbook can be examined to verify the payment of bill. Difference between creditors and bills payable, that bills are to be paid on certain specific time. When the bills mature, then the company is liable to pay it on that specific date. So the auditor will verify that bills are paid on time or not. If it should be check with the bills book, and if it is paid through bank, then bank statement or passbook should be examined to verify that bills are paid on time or not. Second is purchase of land and building. Payment against purchase of either leasehold or freehold land. In case of lease, the auditor considers the terms and condition of the lease. Why terms and condition? Because is it is operating lease or it is capital lease. In case of freehold, auditor consider conveyance deed and receipt issued by the seller for the amount paid. So for the purchase of land and building, both type of transaction can be assessed. Leasehold building, the lease agreement should be examined, and for the freehold building and land purchases, the evidence of the amount paid should be checked, in which deed of agreement and receipt issued by the seller. Plant and machinery, payment against plant and machinery can be checked by the auditor. Watch the purchase of machinery with invoice received from the supplier. In case of imported machinery, any import duty, bill of lading, clearing charges should be assessed and should be debited to the asset account. Copyright and patent right, these are intangible asset of the company. It should be watched with the receipt issued by the seller against payment made to him. An agreement of copyright or patent right should be examined by the auditor. Purchase of payment and copyrights payment should be examined. If developed through R&D, then all expenses incurred on R&D should be examined by the auditors. is shown in order to ascertain the cost of that specific patent. Deferred expenditure means that their benefit are not consumed in a single period. It is it spread over over different accounting period. It is a revenue expenditure which is not completely written off in the year in which it is incurred, but will be spread over the year during which it is at benefits are available. Example are preliminary expenses. When the company is going to was going to set up, their initial expenses are called preliminary expenses. Research and development expenditure, these expenditures cannot be consumed in a single period. Underwriting commission is a commission that is paid for to the broker against the services received in issuance of share and debenture. Unexpired insurance, it is also deferred expenditure because insurance purchased in 1 month in a year cannot consumed in a single month. It is spread over 12 months. How to treat deferred expenditure? Auditor has to see only right revenue expenditure is treated as deferred revenue expenditure. Sometimes the company purchase and sometimes the company's incurred an expenditure in order to overstate the profit, they deferred it to the next period. In this way, they overstate the current year profit. So, right revenue expenditure should be examined. We should see only that exceptional revenue expenditure are treated as deferred expenditure, and normal revenue expenditure are not treated as deferred expenditure to inflate the profit of the business. The client policy. Client means the company to whom the auditor is giving the services. Auditor has to discuss with the management of the company or with the management of the client to understand clearly the policies of the client in respect of amortization of these deferred revenue expenditure. By amortization means it is allocated again as an expense over a different period of time. For example, if the company have a policy to amortize it over a 10 year, let's suppose our preliminary expenses are 110 million and it is spread over 10 years. So in 1 year they will charge 1 million as an expense against the revenue of that specific year. Again, estimated time, that how much is the estimated time of the deferred revenue expenditure in which it should be written off completely. Auditor should see the estimate of the number of year over which the deferred revenue expenditure is required to be written off is being correctly made. He should also see that the estimates made is supported by adequate and reliable evidence. Correct calculations. Auditor should check the calculation of writing off the deferred revenue expenditure relative to vouchers are properly made. Accuracy of the transaction. Auditor should examine whether deferred revenue expenditure and return off are treated correctly in the book. He should see that the return off portion of the deferred revenue expenditure is charged or debited to profit and loss account, and the unwritten of portion of the deferred revenue expenditure is carry forward. Watching deferred revenue expenditure, a reasonable amount. Auditor should verify whether the amount of deferred revenue expenditure written off and charged to the profit and loss account is reasonable or not. This is purely on the judgment of the management and judgment of the auditor, because reasonable have no quantifiable range. Proper distribution. Auditor should see that the proper sorry, proper distinction has been made between exceptional losses, such as losses due to fire, flood, earthquake should not be treated as deferred revenue expenditure. He should see that exceptional losses are not treated as deferred revenue expenditure. Arithmetical accuracy, auditor should see the amount of unwritten of portion of deferred revenue expenditure is correct or not. He should see that the unwritten portion of the deferred revenue expenditure is an asset on the asset side of the balance sheet until it is completely written off. Preliminary expenses. These are the expenses incurred when, at the time of floating of giant stock company, at the time of making or making a giant stock company, also known as promotion expenses. It include investigation charges, means market survey, cost of issue of share and debenture initially, it should be included in the preliminary expenses, underwriting commission, the person, the broker or the investment bank who are involved in issuing of these issuance of share and debenture, his commission should also be included in preliminary expenses. Fees paid to the preparation of the document, initially memorandum of association, article of association, fee paid to the consultant to develop these document. Fee paid for registration, it should be included in preliminary expenses. Expenses on the prospectus, in printing the prospectus, should also be included in preliminary expenses. These expenses are not treated as a single period expenses. It is amortized over estimated time periods to charge there some portion against the profit and loss of that specific year. Auditor should ascertain whether the expenses are authorized by appropriate authority, whether these expenses are incurred within the sanction limit or not. Cash vouchers and bank passbook are examined for having paid these expenses. Show their initial occurrence of this transaction should be vouched against the source document. Vouching of cost of issuing of shares. It include marketing expenses of the shares, the broker or any other person who is going to make a marketing campaign to buy the share of that specific company. Marketing of fresh issues, initial public offering involves direct selling or selling through underwriters. Marketing of fresh issue, initial IPO, involves direct selling or selling through underwriters. In case of direct selling, bankers to the company play a major role. It means banker work as a broker or facilitate for issuing of these shares to the general public. His initial deposit and subsequent call will have to be paid to the company's banker, because the people who are willing to buy the shares, they will initially deposit their money and subsequently call their money. Subsequently, bank calls them to deposit extra money in order to purchase the share. So cost of marketing commission payable to the banker for collecting money and other service charges have to be vouched. Auditor should examine the passbook of the bank with IPO accounts are maintained, and the agreement copied between the bank and the company should be vouched. Vouching of underwriting commission. What is underwriting commission? It is a commission paid to the underwriter. Who is underwriter? The person who facilitate issuance of shares. Auditor should look into the agreement between the company and the underwriter regarding the commission payable. He has to find out whether the commission is paid only on marked application or not. If the issue is not fully subscribed, he must check whether the underwriter has discharged his liability before the commission is paid. Mean the share should be fully subscribed, otherwise he is not liable to charge any commission. He should ascertain whether the commission calculation has been properly made or not. That is basically arithmetical accuracy of the commission. Thank you. This is all about today's lecture.